What a beautiful day. A beautiful day to go on my next project. I've been trying to do a lot of spring cleaning up here, but I just had to, it can't be all work. So I had to take time to work on my 200-inch TV screen. Yeah, this is my starter kit. I'm going to work my way up to a 300. So this is just a prototype, just getting this going. So I decided to start with a puny little 200-inch screen. So I got the screen inside. I'll show you that. And I'll show you the projector that I use. And yeah, it's just a fun little video. I know it's a departure from radio, but just I'm always doing something just weird up here. So in order to get the screen, I had to make a frame. All right, so I'll walk you through how I did the frame. And then, yeah, I'll go through it here. All right, so it consists of PVC, inch and a half PVC. As you can see, the PVC. I use fence rails. These are on the corners there. Excuse the mess, I'm still cleaning up here. But on the sides here, those are fence rails. I believe they're 10 feet fence rails. All right, it's fence railed out, and the rest is PVC. All right, so what I did, I'll show the guy ropes in a second here. Okay, coming down here, I'll walk you through here. Like I said, inch and a half PVC. There's a T right there. All right, and this rail, this fence rail, it only goes down like 8 inches deep. It's just enough to keep it from kicking, or the bottom kicking out. The guy ropes really keep it locked in place. So 8 inches deep, about. And then the guy wires keep it tight. And then I have, I don't know if you can see that, I have a hose clamp tightened around there. So this will stop. And I can loosen that up and adjust this to keep this whole thing, get it level. So perfect. It's a stop and adjustable, so I can level it. And another thing I did here in this T, I put, excuse this rope, I get this out of here. I put this, This isn't glued together because I don't want to take it apart at the end of summer. So I killed two birds with one stone. What I did was this: there's an eye bolt right here, okay. And I'll show you. I'll show you what these are. Little carabiners. These little locks are adjustable. So the eye bolt goes in there and it goes through the pipe, through the fitting into the pipe, so it keeps the lock in place. Okay, so killed two birds with one stone there. And then coming across here, there's just a four-way. Okay. And over here, same thing as the other side. Not glued in, but yeah, that eye bolt keeps it locked in place, and I need it anyhow. There's an adjustable carabiner to tie the corners down. Okay, so now going up. Same thing up there. I have hooks. Flags in the way. I'll show you on the other side there. Of course, the sun's coming right in there. Sorry, I can't see. There it is. The sun's right in my eyes. There's little hooks going on top of the fence rail. Comes down. Spikes in the ground. It keeps it nice and tight. And the same thing with that side. And of course, again, a hose clamp up there. Keeps that from sliding down all the way, and I can adjust that to keep it level. Okay, going across. And there's a T. Now the only part I have glued is that side of the T right there. That's the only part that's glued. I know what you're thinking. I was going to fall apart. No, it's the way this is now. It is sturdy. It is pretty well locked in place. There's not much to it. Now, like I said, this is a starter kit. I don't want to sink a lot of money into this and then have it not work out, and then, because that would be a bummer. So I'm considering, the only weak part about this is when I put the screen up, it takes a hell of a wind load. Even a little bit of a breeze puts a lot of pressure on it, and wind blows that way, it blows a little bit, you know. I don't know, I could come out with a bracket and secure it to there, or I can bring a support coming up here and another support to support that in the middle there, something like that. But for now, it is working really well. That's about all there is on the frame. All right, let's go inside and I'll show you the screen. And then, yeah, we'll come back out and, yeah, get the screen hung up. All right, I'll be back. All right, before I get the screen hung up outside, here we are inside on my basement floor. Just want to show you the screen itself and what I use to hang the screen. Now, I know a lot of people, what I've seen online, they use these bungee balls. Well, the first night I used that, I found that, see, this screen comes down at night. After the movie, it comes down because I want to leave it up in case it rains or a storm comes through. And like I said, this is a sail. The decent wind puts a tremendous amount of force on that frame out there. So this definitely comes down at the end of the night. So anyhow, up on the ladder at night, dark, even the porch light on, these are stretched tight. And I'm trying to be up on the ladder, trying to get my fingers in there, you know, up on top of the ladder. No, I'm not going to do that. So I got these online as well. And now, like I said, I keep saying this, I'll try to remember, put the link in the description. These S-hooks, all right. So these S-hooks, and by the way, this screen has grommets on all four sides. All right, so these S-hooks fit perfectly right into these grommets. And here's the screen itself. I know it's kind of a little hard to see there. Got a nice black border on it, decent material. It says it's canvas. That gives it down 8 feet. Of course, it's all kind of scrunched up right now, 14 foot wide. And yeah, it takes me about like 5 minutes to get the screen down, get my little A-frame ladder, get up there, and just pop them right off. Okay, and before I forget, I use these little cam jam things for the corner. When I was out there, I'm going to show you how I put the eye hooks and the corner tees. These seem to work out pretty good. So one piece of rope would be permanently tied to the corners on either side. Oh, I found out too that I don't need to have all the grommets on the bottom, on that bottom rail tied down. I found that just on the corners, pulled tight, keeps the screen nice and flat. So I'm gonna use these. So one piece of rope on the corner, permanently tied on, you feed that through. See that little thing right there? You just pull that tight and it cinches the rope tight. And that's it. So the S-hook method is working out perfect. And like I said, these are rubberized. So they grip just a tiny bit where you can pull it tight, but not so tight when I'm up on a ladder trying to pull the whole screen tight. They slide just a little bit. It's like a perfect medium. So this is the screen. All right, now the projector. Look at this little thing. Little Pericat. I'm shocked. At first I thought that, you know, I don't want to spend that much money and, you know, it's $289, you know, probably get what you pay for. But I'm blown away. I can't believe it. I cannot, because I've seen the price on some of these things. High quality ones. I know this is a Sony. One of the Sony's top of the line. I think it's like $80,000. But you can spend up to like $5,000 on some of these. $3,000. Pretty expensive, but I can't believe it. I can't believe it. You guys will see when I go out there. Not much to it. I want you guys to check out the specs when I put the link in the description. Let's do a little walk around here. Not much to the back. Comes with a remote. Of course, the buttons on top. Coming over here. I'll let that music on in my shop there. Got two HDMI. Ports, USB. The one I have a little dot on there, that's the one I use. That's HDMI 1. And there's a headphone jack. So I plug my cell phone in. Of course, I use a cord HDMI on one end and Type C on the other. It plugs into my phone. And if I'm out of range of my Wi-Fi, it doesn't matter because I have unlimited data on my phone. Now it's going through the cellular. Sometimes you'll notice a little bit of a picture quality dip, but. I don't know, it's pretty darn convenient. But most of the time, it catches my Wi-Fi in the house here. And then, I can either put my headphones in, or what I've been doing, I use my little Bugani little box here. Just connect the headphone cord, pops into here. I keep the volume down, put this thing next to me, and yeah, it works great. And that's all there is. This little tiny thing. All right, I'm about ready to get out there and hang the screen up, and we'll keep this party going. All right, got the screen up. That just took me a few minutes. I'll show you close up what I was talking about. If you can see that, zoom in there. Now I guess I could, if I could get more attention, I could secure it up that way too. Sorry, my fingers make it out of focus. But as you can see, that's got wrinkles in it because it's been sitting on my basement floor. But at night, you don't when the movie's playing, you don't see that. Now one thing, hopefully, I'm gonna have to film while this is playing on my GoPro, because I'll be using my phone as the player. The PVC behind this, during light scenes, you can see it reflecting just a hair, but I have black paint, black spray paint. I'll probably end up painting that. But not bad, not bad. I guess I could do the corner up there, pull a little bit tighter, but like I said, as you see during the movie, you really don't notice it. So that's a 6-foot stepladder right there. So hold on here. We'll get down by my fire pit. Got the fire going. I got that. If you see smoke, it's my barbecue chicken. I got that going on the grill right now. Yeah, but this is all down by my fire pit. All right. Let's go back up and look at those little adjustable carabiners. They work pretty good. They're so-so. Perhaps I'm not using quite the right rope for it. But it's doing its trick. One thing I do like about it, though, this is fabric. It's gonna, depending on temperature and everything, it's gonna, stretch and move. So you just come over here, give a little tug on a string right here, and it tightens up. I gotta get this old rope out. I had this here just in case. But, there you go. But like I said, I'm working through this. This is just kind of prototype. Enjoying the prototype. Same on this side here. I'll get this all down to a science. But, yep. Hold on here. So, not bad. But, I don't know, maybe tug on here. I don't know. We'll figure this all out, but, all right. I'm going to get my table set up and get the projector out here. It's looking pretty good. You can see it's a little bit breezy. I see the flag. And then you can see that moving just a little bit. So with that little bit of a breeze, not too shabby. All right, let me get my table set up. All right, screen up. My chair, my brother's planning on coming over. Got my Bugatti plugged in. Got the extra long cord. Here's my table here. Like I said, this is all kind of prototype. But there's my phone charger. That way I can put that on charge. It stays charged up while I'm watching a movie. Prop it up there. And like I said, there's the HDMI cord. Comes out. Now then it plugs into my Sally Telly. And once it's plugged in, I put it on the charger here. And then, pull up Amazon Prime and I can watch all my movies. So, anyhow, then I'll adjust these chairs here. So it's not in the, should be out of the viewing angle. If it is, I can scooch those chairs just a pinch out of the way. Look, it'll be in the way there. But, there it is. This thing's massive. I could probably do a little bit of a better job. Maybe I could tie these in, just a hair. I don't know. I'll see. But, there it is. You know what? Hang on. Let me get a... There's an ugly shed in the background. Hold on here. Let me get my tape measure out and give you a brief. A lot of people don't say how far back this is. Hang on 1 second. Let me go in and grab my tape measure. All right. Wow, I can't believe it. I found my tape measure. All right, so that's every bit of, 22 feet. Now, depending on when the movie was made, or what I'm trying to get at is the aspect ratio. Some of the older movies, they're more, I don't know the aspect ratios, but I can move this table up or back to fill up the screen. And then some of the newer movies, they have that black bar going across, the cinematic look. But if especially on Amazon watching movies, if you tap the screen up in the right-hand corner, upper right, a little menu comes up. If you tap zoom, it'll take up the entire picture, entire frame. So that's pretty cool, because I was watching a movie last night, it was about maybe like a foot black bar at the bottom, a foot on top, wasn't filling my screen. So you just tap that zoom button and then there you go. It takes up the entire screen. So the movies don't have that. Like I said, I adjust my table. I'll bring it in, move it forward or backward. But as it sets right now, I can't test it out right now because it's a little bit too bright. But yeah, I'm sure they'll adjust it. But yeah, 22 feet. And that screen is 14 feet wide and 8 feet high. So, all right, now I'll probably be back with my GoPro because my cell phone will be in use. So, got a little bit of time here. Got a little bit of daylight left before she goes into the woods out there. All right. I'll be back with the something started and with the GoPro. All right, I shall return. Okay, I know I said I wasn't going to use the bungee balls, but I am. I decided to use them on the sides, which isn't so bad. It's that up there. I don't want to get the ladder out at nighttime, be messing with those. But it did improve pretty good. So maybe I will tie some of the sides off. As you can see, nothing across the bottom. Just the corner, maybe like a 45 degree angle. And then, yeah, it improved it. Now, of course, I ran out of bungee balls. Well, secretly, I have them. I just can't find them in my mess inside. So, yeah, I ran out of them. But, yeah, there you go. I just doubled them up. I'd use a wire tie on that one. And that one right there. So, yeah, I don't think I'm going to put one right there. It's kind of hard to get to because it's low right here. I'm gonna break my neck, but that did improve. Okay, with that said, the next video clip will be just a movie. I won't say anything, and yeah, you'll see. At nighttime, it's hard to get a size reference, but at least you'll be able to see the quality. So there it is. All right, with that said, this is the 200 inch screen starter kit. I proved that this can work good, and nowhere to go but up. 300 in screen coming soon, maybe next summer. But going bigger, boys. All right, with that said, here we go. Here's the movie, and I'll talk to you guys later.
Who are you guys?
My name's Kansas, and this is my little man, Toto. We're jesters from up in Big Cliff. Come down and check out your place. Is this it? Is this your place?
Yeah.
Nice.
Tell me, if you two are jesters, what's our credo?
Credo? Well, you almost got me there. There's no credo. Other than
the center of the floor. Yeah, and oh, that's all he's giving him, folks. That's a bucket full of confidence right there. Over to new guy, David Starkey. Oh, this guy could be trouble. The Wild West, those are six guns full of sexy. The good, the bad, and the groovy.
Starsky, hang on.
No!
Okay, I said I wasn't going to be back, but I just want to mention a couple of things here. That center pole right there, I have to spray paint that black because, as you can see in some of the footage, it just reflects too much. But other than that, I call it a success. Now, it's not like sitting in your living room with a, you know, QLED or OLED screen and everything, but it is what it is. It's an outdoor event. It's more than just a movie. It's about having family over, cooking on a grill out here, and enjoying the beautiful night sky. But Yeah, so I'm going to work my way up and, yeah, go from here. I smell a 300-inch screen on the way. Yeah. All right, everybody take care. God bless. I'm going to bed. Buena noche.